What are the 5 must-dos to start wholesaling houses without using your cash or credit, whether you are a newbie or someone that has been banging their head against a brick wall to get started? Well, I'm going to give you those 5 must-dos. Stand by. Let's get it. Hello guys, this is Ty, aka The Flip Man. What are the 5 must-dos to start wholesaling houses without using your cash or credit? If you're just starting out as a newbie, or if you've been trying to do this but keep running into a brick wall, hopefully these 5 must-dos will help you get closer to your first check. Okay, number 1, knowledge. You must educate yourself. We all know in order to do anything successfully, you need to be able to talk the talk and or at least sound like you know what you're talking about. This will go a long way with dealing with sellers and buyers. Where and how you educate yourself is important, but at the end of the day, as long as you get the information needed to help you close deals, then mission accomplished. Please make sure, no matter the source that you choose, that you get everything you need in one purchase and not a continuous upsell. A lot of you know what I'm talking about. An example of that is they start out free with a 2-hour seminar. The next step, if you want the 3-day seminar, $200 to $300. The next step, if you want the Shazam version, $3,000. And then if you want personal coaching, $30,000. I'm sure you've experienced that sequence of offers and you still don't know what you're doing. I'm not hating on them. Do what you do. But the true red flag is the guy that they're marketing, that it's his program and his system. If he's not there or she's not there, then beware. Now, in larger cities, occasionally they will show up, but the other red flags should be obvious to you, from free to 197 to 3,000 to 30,000. That's called an upsell. I guess you say, Flip Man, don't you sell courses? Yes, I do. But where I'm different, not saying I'm better, is that I give away the information through my 300 plus YouTube videos that anyone can access for free. And many have taken advantage of those videos and done deals, as you will see on my channel. But if someone wants to get into my time, and it's actual my time, you would deal directly with me if you took my step-by-step courses along with coaching through deals, then yeah, there's going to be a cost for that, because you have access to nearly 16 years of doing what you want to do as the date of this video. Number 2, time. Only you will know, but determine how much time you have to dedicate to the biz. The most valuable asset that we all have is time. And I'm sure some of you say, I don't have a lot of time to put into this because of family, work, school. People that follow me already know what I'm about to do. Let me ask you a question. Do you know how many hours are in a week? I'll tell you, 168. Is that a lot of time or is it not a lot of time? So let me just break it down to what I think would be an average person that's pretty busy. Let's start with the basics. Most people have employment. If this doesn't fit you, then there's really no excuse on why you can't dive into this. But let's assume that someone works anywhere from 40 to 60 hours per week. That may be one job or it may be multiple jobs. So we're going to use the number 60. So subtracting 60 from the 168, now we have 108 hours left in a week. We know you have to sleep. So we would give you 8 hours per night to sleep. That totals 56 hours that is subtracted from the 108. Now you have 52 hours left. What are we going to do with those other 52? Well, I'm not going to be a hard you know what here, but I'll give you 4 hours per day to just do whatever you want to do, commuting, family time, whatever, social media, Netflix, whatever you want to do, 4 hours per day. I think that's a reasonable amount of time for just you time. So 4 times 7 is 28. So now you have 24 hours left out of that 168. I gave you 60 hours to work, 56 hours to sleep, and 28 hours to do whatever you want to do per week. So you now have 24 hours in a week to do this. That's 3.4 hours per day to work at changing your financial situation. No excuses when it comes to time. I really could end the video here because time is not an excuse. We say money or credit is not an excuse. Everything else is left up to you. But well, there's more. So we'll continue on with number three. So before I continue with number three, just an additional thought on the time aspect because it's important. And I know everyone's schedules are different. Their life situations are different. But only you can look in the mirror and say, am I taking advantage of the best use of my time to change my financial situation? Maybe you have to give up your Netflix subscription and sell your Xbox. I don't know. So on with number three, contracts, paper up. What docs do I need to put deals together? The reason you can make money wholesaling real estate without using your cash or credit is because you can lock up great deals using a contract, AKA a purchase and sales agreement. Well, you say, where can I get a contract? Well, that's an easy fix because I give away the one-page contract that I've been using since 2003 and has been used all over the country. Well, you say, well, would this contract work in my state? Well, I just told you it's used all over the country, but just to break this down even more, you and a seller can literally write up an executable contract on the hood of your car as long as you're not performing something illegal. It can be as basic as the seller is the seller, you are the buyer, 123 Main Street is the address, I'm buying as is, a price, earnest money, and a date that you're going to close. That's basically a contract. Now, obviously, they can get a little bit more detail and a lot more detail than that. That's why my contract has worked all over the country because of the simplicity of it. Again, it's free, in which you can download a free copy from my site, flipman.net. Just a side note, if you're going to deal with real estate agents, they will not use my contract or any other contract. The only contract that they will use is the contract already pre-approved by the Board of Realtors for that particular market and or state. So don't rack your brain on the contract part of it. If you have a seller and a buyer in place, the paperwork is the easy part. As a bonus, you can also get a free copy of the closing detail sheet that I use to simply instruct the title company or the closing attorney on who's who, who's paying what, and who's receiving what. You can get a copy of that at freeclosingdoc.com. Number four, setting up your communications. In order for sellers and buyers to contact you, you need phone numbers, social media, email, and or websites. Now, some of those can wait depending on your level of technology, but phone numbers can't wait because this will be the main method that sellers and buyers will contact you. You will want multiple phone numbers to track the different methods of marketing used to generate leads. And when I say tracking, the reason that you do that is that you simply want to know what's working and what's not working so you can adjust accordingly. There are several free to inexpensive phone services that can provide multiple phone numbers that can be forwarded to your existing smartphone, but also receive and send text messages along with voicemail options. So finally, number five, and this is the big one, marketing and advertising to get your phone ringing. If you don't get anything else out of this video, please pay attention to number five must do. Leads, leads, leads. I'm no smarter than you are, and there's no magic wand that I'm waving to do deals. But what I did recognize when I first educated myself about wholesaling real estate, mainly houses, is that in order to consistently do deals, is that I need to keep my phone ringing. Now, there are several methods to generating leads, but the great thing about it, these methods are free to inexpensive to help you generate thousands of dollars per deal. So let's start with a couple of free methods. Driving for dollars. This is simply where you get into your vehicle and you drive around looking for properties. Vacant properties, in a lot of cases, will stand out because they may be boarded up, high grass, the front door is open. We've all seen them. While you're out driving for dollars, don't only just look for vacant houses. You can also look for properties that are for sale by owner. They simply have a sign in the yard that says for sale by owner. Also, properties that are for rent. You say, well, why would I target that property? Well, the largest group of individuals that will contact you, no matter what form of marketing you're doing, is tired landlords. So you can be proactive and reach out to them and simply call them and say, hey, is this property still available? Where it is available or not, you let them know, well, I'm not calling about renting the property, but would you be interested in selling the property? And you go from there. And in a lot of cases, if they don't want to sell that property, they may have another property that they may be interested in selling. Here's another free method. Co-wholesaling or joint venturing with another wholesaler, or they call it JVing. And what that simply is another wholesaler may have deals that they can't move for whatever reason, but they're actually deals. They may be green as you are, but they've actually found a deal and you're more educated on finding a buyer than they are. So you would partner with them to wholesale their property. Now, how you split the money will be up to your negotiations. I generally look to do at least 50-50 and or they give me a price and anything that I make above that, I keep. That's called co-wholesaling. Now the paperwork, I normally still go with a purchase and sales agreement. Some people use a joint venture agreement. I want to be directly in the chain of the sale with a purchase and sales agreement, but that's just my preference. Okay, so now here are some of the faster, less frustrating methods, but not free. So let's start with direct mail. These are the yellow letters and or postcards you may have heard of and obviously probably have seen before. To better explain, this is simply targeting sellers via the mail using postcards and or letters saying, hey, I want to pay cash for your house fast, with your contact information. Now, it'd be a little more detailed than that, but you get the basics of it. With any form of marketing, your goal is to get the seller's attention. With direct mail, your first goal is to avoid the trash can. And the method that I use to decrease the chances of my mailer being thrown in the trash is using the brilliant idea of placing a photo of the owner's property on the mailer, normally a postcard. So yes, the actual property that I'm targeting from that owner, it will include an actual photo of that property, as you can see on the screen here. Brilliant. So I ask you the question, do you think this will increase your chances of getting your message read and of course avoiding the trash can? So if you're interested in using that same method of direct mail marketing, simply go over to mailtoflip.com. That's mailtoflip.com. A link should be in the description and or comments of this particular video. Now, with direct mail, a couple of things. You need a list in order to start your direct mail campaign. One of the places that I would recommend you getting your list from is dealulator.com. This will allow you to create and build your list to target through direct mail. So simply get over to dealulator.com to start building your list for your direct mail. Another side note, just understanding with direct mail or any form of marketing, you must be consistent. And what I mean by that, you know what your budget is for your business, for your marketing. If you have to get a second income to fund your marketing, that's what I would do. Remember that time I was talking about? And what I mean by being consistent, you want to know who you're mailing to, how many you're mailing to, and how often, and be consistent with that plan to produce results. You only need one deal to pay for your marketing for an entire year that will send you into orbit as far as doing more deals. The next method is cold calling. This has slowly become number one for me because of how inexpensive and fast you can start generating leads. Even though I hate doing it myself, but I'm smart enough to team up with individuals to do what I don't like or can't do. I suggest you do the same if you're not good at cold calling. Now, out of need, I would do it, but fortunately enough, again, I'm smart enough to give up a share of what I'm making to those individuals that are good at it, whether that's a friend, family member, or just someone that you can partner with. They even have virtual assistants that will do that for you. Not my preference, but those exist also as an option. So who are you actually calling? So what I do is a double dip from the direct mail list that I purchased. I also would turn that into a list that I can call. Now with the direct mail, I can mail to everybody on the list, whereas with the cold calling, I may only be able to get a percentage of the list with phone numbers, which is fine because of the immediate response rate versus direct mail. Both are needed because you're leaving money on the table if you don't do one or the other, but they're just different. But again, I can use that same list for cold calling that I purchased for direct mail. And just to remind you, you can get your list at dealulator.com. So who am I targeting? I normally target absentee owners, also known as non-owner occupied properties. And the reason I do that is I'm taking a shotgun approach because I'm trying to reach motivated sellers of all different types, such as tired landlords, vacant property owners, probates, out-of-town owners, possible pre-foreclosures, house that needs too many repairs. I think you get the point. So last but not least, the old trusted bandit sign. So this is the first method that I used because it made sense for me, being that I'm an introvert, but I'm not when someone calls me wanting something because they saw one of my advertisements. The reason that bandit signs work so well, if done correctly, is because you're taking advantage of thousands of eyeballs for pennies on the dollar to make thousands from those pennies. They are basically mini billboards. And yes, all cities, counties, and I guess the state level, have ordinances against bandit signs, no matter where you are. But there's also laws against speeding, and people still do it. I said that, of course, to be cute, but that's real. Bandit signs are nothing new. If you're starting out, the simple thing to do, if you're not sure where to place them, is to simply copycat where others are placing signs in your market. You may have to get outside of your comfort zone in a lot of cases, but you want to place signs where others are placing signs. Because guess what? The guys that have been using them for years, they already know what part of your market they can get away with them. Now, nothing prevents you from testing in areas where they don't exist. But when I say testing, I mean 5 or 10, see how long they stay up. They stay up a week or two. You may want to add some more. And one last note on bandit signs, keep it simple. Make sure your message is very simple. Remember, people don't have a lot of time to read your message. They're reading from a distance. So the larger your text, we buy houses, and a phone number, the easier it is to convey your message. So these are the 5 must-dos to start wholesaling houses without using your cash or credit. Whether you are a newbie or you've been banging your head against the wall to close a deal, this should help you get started. And remember, I have the 300 plus videos right here on YouTube. Make sure you subscribe to the channel. Thanks, and I will see you on the flip side.